Let us now study about thin lenses. About thin lenses, here we can write that these are thin transparent region which are bounded by two spherical surfaces. Based on the type of spherical surfaces which are bounding the region, here the lenses can be divided into two categories. Here we can write there are two types of lenses. One by one, here we can discuss these lenses. The very first one is intersecting surface lenses, which are also called convex lenses. These are the lenses in which the surfaces which are bounding the region forming a lens are intersecting each other. Like if you just have a look on this system where two spherical surfaces are intersecting each other and bounding a region between the two, and this region between the two surfaces we define as a biconvex lens. And here you can see the radius of curvature of the two surfaces on the opposite side of the lens. And for the first surface, the center is on the other side. For the second surface, center is on the other side of the lens. Here we can write if R1 is equals to R2, then it is termed as equiconvex lens. And other type of lens here you can see, if there is a spherical surface and it is intersecting with the a plane surface, and the region bounded between the two surfaces, this will define as a plano-convex lens, where one surface is plane. So here R1 is there, the radius of curvature of one surface, and the radius of curvature of second surface will tend to infinity because one surface is plane, which has infinite radius of curvature. Now, this is the third kind of convex lens, where you can see the two surfaces have their center of curvature on the same side of lens. So, the region bounded is also termed as a meniscus lens. It is a kind of convex lens which is having the shape of meniscus, and is termed as a concavo-convex lens. Here also you can see that the radius of curvature of the two surfaces are always unequal, otherwise the two surfaces will never intersect, and the center of curvature lie on the same side. These all lenses where the two surfaces which are bounding the region between the two surfaces are intersecting each other, and such lenses are termed as convex lenses. Let's continue with the second type of lens on the next sheet. Let us continue with the second type of lenses, which are called non-intersecting surface lenses. These are also called concave lenses. These are the lenses in which the two surfaces bounding the region forming the lens do not intersect each other. Like if this situation, we'll see there are two spherical surfaces which are non-intersecting, and if the region between the two surfaces is filled with a transparent media, then this type of lens we term as a biconcave lens. And here you can see the center of curvature of the two surfaces lie on the opposite side of the lens, and the radius of curvature also on the other side. So here if R1 is equals to R2, that means if the lens is symmetric, then it is called equiconcave lens. We just have a look on the other category when there is a spherical surface and a plane surface which are not intersecting each other. And if the region between the two is filled with a transparent media, then this region which is bounded by two non-intersecting surfaces we term as a plano-concave lens. Here there is one radius of curvature and another radius will tend to infinity. But here you must be careful that unlike to plano-convex lens where the two surfaces intersect, in case of plano-concave lens, the surfaces do not intersect. And the third category of lens, which we term as convexo-concave lens, there's a lens in which the radius of curvature as well as center of curvature of the two spherical surfaces lie on the same side and the two surfaces do not intersect. Here you can see in this picture the region between the two surfaces which are having the center of curvature on the same side of lens. If the region is filled with the transparent medium, then the resulting lens formed is termed as convexo-concave lens. And here you can see, unlike to the first case of biconvex lens here, both the centers of the two surfaces lie on the same side of lens. From the next section onward, we'll study about the behavior of these lenses for various light rays.